Hello, am I audible to all? Hello. Yeah, hello everyone. I'm Kapil Meghani, Zonal Chair for Youth at ISHRAE and Chair for Webinars ISHRAE. So first of all, I would like to thank Sunil sir for taking his time and giving us this webinar. First of all, I would like to introduce Sunil Sood sir. He's the oldest member of ISHRAE. He has joined ISHRAE in 1988 in Bangalore chapter. So knows about the working of ISHRAE, being the initial member of Bangalore chapter at that time. And he is the founder member and former president of Indian Association of Energy Management Professionals. Under his leadership, IAMPA has initiated several activities to make India an energy efficient nation. Highly passionate and committed to energy conservation and efficiency, he has also written several articles on matters related to energy efficiency and pioneered the Home Energy and Resources Management Program for Sustainable Development. Also, he has formed the new associations to work on sustainability and initiating the green movement by making the Association of Green Industries and Services. And also, he is the director of LCG Energy Consultants Private Limited. Also, he is the recipient of several awards under Indo-German cooperation programs. He was honored for his achievements for environment protection and energy efficiency by several bodies, including Consulting Engineers Association, Rotary Club, Brahma Kumaris, etc. Also, he is passionately involved with various groups working on cleanliness. Recently, he formed the Bangalore Roadies, which is very popular in Bangalore nowadays, and working with the local municipal bodies to clean the city and awareing the citizens about sustainability and green movement. So hats off to the movement. So I would like now like to invite Sunil sir to take the lead and start the webinar. Thank you all.
Hello.
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Can I start?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you very much, Kapil, for the nice, wonderful introduction. And thanks, ISHRAE team, for inviting me. Today's topic, as you are all aware, is about managing energy and resources for sustainability. So what is sustainability? I will directly come to that. Actually, it relates to ability to sustain. So what we want to sustain, how long we want to sustain, for whom we want to sustain, and how we want to do it. So the question arises then, what we exactly mean by that? Actually, sustainability is nothing but about sustainable development. And in the early 80s, United Nations had taken initiatives to consider how the development should happen, because in a finite planet, our Earth, we couldn't have infinite or unlimited development at the cost of environment and society and all that. That is how a Brundtland Commission was formed, and they defined sustainable development as the development that meets the needs of the present without sacrificing the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. But this definition had certain drawbacks. It was not defined what is need and other things. So there were many other points were added. In my view, in the simple definition of sustainability, it should mean that what is the carrying capacity of Mother Earth, means how much Earth can bear. That development should be called sustainable development. And before last year, United Nations had come out with the Sustainable Development Goals 2030. And under that, earlier to that, there were three dimensions of sustainable development. That is economic sustainability, social sustainability, and environmental sustainability. Economic means prosperity, means profit. And social means people, that is P. And planet means environmental sustainability. So there were earlier three P's. Then United Nations added two more P's, that is partnership and peace. So as you can see in the slide, five P's of sustainable development, when all the five P's are in balance, that development will be sustainable. So I will go to my presentation. So as you can see in the slide, there United Nations had declared Sustainable Development Goal 2030, in that there were 17 goals to be met and there were 169 targets under different goals. So our topic of energy and resources, most of the goals cover those topics. Finally, it was also thought of by United Nations what should be the way forward to sustainable development. Then in 2011, UNEP produced a report on green economy. It was decided that we need to green the economy, and that is how we can achieve sustainable development. The green economy is nothing but it is low carbon, and it is resource efficient, and it is inclusive. So this is how green economy was defined. But here, coming to my presentation, how this sustainability is linked with what we need to do right from our homes, on offices, in industry, wherever we are. And this my presentation is in two parts. One first part is sensitization. Because unless we are all fully sensitized, unless we know why we need to do it, what we need to do, how we need to do, when we need to do, we will not be taking action. We will remain unaware, we'll be blissfully ignorant. So to wake up that, I prepared two presentations. One is sensitization, another is action. So once people get sensitized, then they understand the importance and urgency of, and the need, then they get into action mode. So as I was telling you, there are five P's of sustainability. Economic citizens means prosperity, profit. See, unless we have economic sustainability, we cannot also sustain progress. So if you see the reasons, economic reasons, we are importing, as far as if you consider India's condition, we are importing 7 lakh crores worth of energy every year, and we are also dependent on nuclear fuel. We are also having 30% of our budget goes into meeting the energy need. Even coal and solar cells we are importing. And another economic reason is subsidies are there. Even today's paper you can see the LPG subsidy again gone up, and oil also prices are going up, and because of that all energy has to be subsidized, and it adds to the burden, economic burden. And another thing is, if we save energy and resources, we'll be sparing with others, those who don't have. As we can see that 20% of population doesn't have the resource, access to electricity or clean fuel. So if we save and if we share, then that can be utilized for economic growth of the backward class people. You can see this. See, one third of world's extreme poor reside in India. That is the condition. So this is part of social reasons. Social reason means related to society. That is another P, that is people. So this is the second P reasons where we have the, you know, on one hand Ambanis and on other hand slums coexisting. This is how our people is still, many are sleeping or collecting firewood and also using firewood for cooking, which is, you know, pollutes their dwellings, and they inhale a lot of smoke equivalent to 20 cigarettes. And then coming to third reason, environmental reason, that is planet. See, our consumption of energy and resources is causing a lot of pollution, and land pollution, water pollution, air pollution, all sorts of pollutions it causes. So if we manage energy and resources efficiently, then this also helps the third P, that is planet, environmental, that is environmental reasons. So finally, when we see, we cannot say that it is the act of God, it is just come. It is all because we are misusing, we are abusing energy and resources. You can, I'll show you some of the clips, cases where we found, like starting with electricity. You can see here how the fixture without reflector is there, how close to the window they put the lights. Then hidden lighting is a norm. Instead of direct, where we want the light, how much light we need, where we need, that fundamental principle of lighting is forgotten. Then this is how we leave lights and on. Then thermostat setting, we don't bother, we unnecessarily keep more thermostat setting. And here in this case, there is no switch also, and directly connected to the socket, so it, the geyser keeps switching on and off. And on one or two places, many places rather, we'll see that geyser switch is very close to the light switch. So by mistake, some people switch it on, and then that geyser keeps heating and cooling water. So water wastage we do, and we use running hose to clean our car, which we demonstrate that we can clean our car with 1 liter of water. Food we waste. We don't even care that with what difficulty food has been produced, firstly by the farmer, then cooked, and then we don't hesitate to waste that. Then there are certain things which are related to prestige. Here you can see one over lighting, because corporator wants to compete with another corporator. He has put so many sodium vapor lamp, I will also put. And another having here down, you can see one lawyer, he's a very influential, he has put up so many lights. And another place you can see one tea shop fellow also has more light, because his rent includes electricity bill, so he has put up so many lights. And we have hypocrisy of oil marketing companies. On the one hand, they want to encourage, you know, petroleum product, to save petroleum product. On the other hand, they give cash purchase awards. So this is all not working in the tandem. Then here you can see, it looks like the big conference is going to happen, but here it is Lal Bagh, Bangalore, where people come in cars, and they come in the morning, and not only cause the fuel consumption, they spoil the air quality also, for the very purpose for which they come to Lal Bagh. And you can see even tree guards, the resources are simply, many places are lying here. Tree guards are, after even the trees have grown up big, they're not removed. And in one place in Hyderabad, I saw that the tree guard was growing along with the tree, and no one had bothered to remove. This type of you know, steel which is lying waste, I have calculated equivalent to about 2 million ton of steel. You can see people, especially in offices and all that, they don't bother to repair. The repair has been totally forgotten. They directly want to buy new one, and they leave them get rusted, and then it is sold as per kg rate. Even our police people, they confiscate the vehicle, then they don't bother for that. And even the people don't want to take back the vehicle, and it will be lying in front of the police station and getting rusted, and resources being wasted. We have got money, now we have become rich, but we have become insecure. Our homes are now like jails. And you can see most of the homes having unnecessary too much of steel structures for their safety. then packaging. We are doing so much over packaging that it has become now a big issue. And everyone now realizing that, especially being plastic pollution, it is that packaging, how we can do eco-friendly packaging. People even give some gifts just like that, they give without consideration. Like many times when I go and speak somewhere, they give me some memento. That memento will have their names and nowhere my name will be there. Then why should I keep it? But they will simply force. And packaging also, they will give one pen. Pen will be inside one container and then again over package. So this type of things not now to needs attention. So why this is happening? Because we fail to give the equal importance to megawatts on and megawatts. See, instead of always thinking of new power plants, we should also think of saving. So that is called megawatt. So if equal importance is given for both, then it will help, because there is a need for 500 megawatt power plant. So if you set up a new power plant, it may cost say 3000 crores. But if I am able to save 500 megawatt, and will I get equal opportunity? But it is not happening. And on the one hand, we want to go on adding more and more power into the grid. On the other hand, we are not bothered for the leakages. So it is just like pouring water in a leaking basket. You can see from this graph that there are leakages in terms of inefficient use, abuse, careless use, theft, and subsidies and all that. But there is no one has plugged those leakages, and without mind plugging, going on adding thermal, wind, hydel, solar, nuclear. So this is a wrong approach. We need to plug the leakages. And then what solutions we get finally? See here that now China is, or many countries are selling oxygen cans. Is it the solution? Instead of doing managing things properly and having lesser pollution, this will again add to more pollution and more wastages. Then there in Bangalore, they spent 5 crore rupees on putting up cycle lane. In the process, they consumed steel, putting the pillar, then they consumed cement, they consumed other things, other resources, and not even single cyclist used that. Rather, now it is being used for car parking. So this way we may think that you are avoiding tree, you save one tree, but this is nothing but being unnecessary emotional. In the process of saving one tree, we have increased the total route and it will consume more fuel. Then we go for, without seeing that we can use those things, we directly put it in the biomethanization plant to produce gas. So how much gas is produced and how much energy is consumed in crushing and bringing this thing, that when is not seen. And we blindly set up some plants for biomethanization and all that. And see how our even festivals are celebrated. I won't like to comment, but we all know what happens to this type of celebrations. We create so much waste. Even in our religious festivals, we create waste. So points to ponder is, we should not only be law our own man-made law. We take pride, I am a law-abiding citizen, but we don't bother for the nature's laws. So we should also take care of the nature's laws and live with the nature. This is all about sensitization. Now I will go to my another presentation, which is action. Hello. Hello. Yeah. So once having realized that there is a need to do something, we must do, we must act. Then what to do? That comes to second part, action. What action we should take? I always tell people that, you see, we should do everything. What has happened? A lot of compartmentalization has happened. People were working in compartments. somebody fond of planting trees, greenery, they only do that. Somebody wants to do only gardening. Somebody wants to only attack plastic. Somebody wants to do only energy saving. Somebody wants to do only plastic, only water saving. So, and somebody attack only traffic problem. Not many are understanding that we need to take up everything. Everyone has to do everything. Under what I was saying that there are 6 W and 1 H. That is, who has to do what? Who has to do who, what has to be done, when has to be done, where it has to be done. That all questions come into picture when we have start taking action. So we everyone has to do everything in a nutshell. I tell everyone should do also save energy, should also save water, should also manage waste, should also find alternatives to polluting items. So it is the time to walk the talk. Instead of simply talking, we need to take action on the ground and not in a isolated or in a compartmentalized manner, but in a holistic and comprehensive manner. How can we do it? How can we start? We can start from our own home. We can start from our office. We can start from wherever we are, because finally, hello. So what I suggest that you should start from your own home. Appoint a member of your family as a home energy and resources manager. See, unless there is a person assigned to do something, some work, that work will not be done. If you don't have any person assigned to do that, who will do that work? So that way we need to assign. One can be himself one home energy manager, or one can, if it's a community, they can assign some security fellow or some other employee or staff member. Then they start making files, start taking consumption data, meter readings, and estimating consumption, all that. So these techniques are required to be sometime taught, like what are how the files to be done, what are the readings to be taken, and how the control is to be done. So I have developed energy pyramid approach. What I say that, if you are not doing anything, you are here now, business as usual. It means your consumption will be this much big. So if you start adopting conservation techniques, those conservation techniques doesn't mean just sacrificing or any taking trouble. It is all smart and intelligent use of resources. So those techniques like how to set a thermostat of fridge, how to set thermostat of AC, how to set thermostat of geyser, and how to take care of ghost consumers, how to use each and every appliance smartly and intelligently. That is all conservation, because here you are not investing anything. You are just learning the tricks how to utilize energy and resources smartly and intelligently. Same way for water, same way for other resources. So this pyramid has foundation of conservation, over which you build efficiency. Like to some extent you can save conservation, then you need to change certain things, retrofitting. Say if you have old fans, you need to change to now new super energy efficient fans have come. That is efficiency. Or lighting, you need to change say old T12 tube light or the LED tube light. That is efficiency. So those things you can incorporate. Over that, you can go also for solar energy, renewable energies, solar lighting, water heater. So this type of pyramid approach is possible both for domestic consumers as well as commercial and industrial consumers. So the second right hand side pyramid you are seeing, that is applicable for commercial and industrial unit. Once we understand this concept, home energy and resources manager or office energy and resources manager or industrial energy and resources manager, we should designate. They may not be full time. One or two employees in every office section can be designated, and they can be taught how to apply those conservation techniques, and then also prepare a plan to change to inefficient from inefficient thing to efficient and also renewable energy. While also doing this, there are certain basic principles we should take care. Because if you don't understand the basic energy concepts and how you have to approach and monitor, then you may not get the desired results. You may not achieve so much saving as you could have done. Like, first you ask yourself, are there better ways to achieve the same objective? And second question, are there better uses for the same resources? If the answer to both is in negative, then only you go for that option. You should choose options. First you decide some 3-4 options. I should do this, I should do that. Then later on ask this question. Can I have the same objective? Can I have the same objective with in a different way, better way? Or now what I am going to spend money on this, is there better uses of the same money? All these questions you should ask. Then also take care of net energy gain, what will be the net energy gain, what will be the payback period, all these things also you should see. And how to start? You start as I suggest, A square, B square, C square approach. AA, BB, CC approach. AA means accounting and accountability. BB means budgeting and best practices. CC means controlling and commitment. See, unless we do both, not only accounting, also accountability, not only budgeting, but best practices also, then not only controlling, but commitment. So this approach, when we adopt, then we get the best results. See, for example, here, accounting and accountability has come here. There, now you see your meter, electricity meter reading you take, your bills you check, then what, same way for water, same way for fuel, same way for even other household purchases. Then when we fix up the accountability of all the consumers or users, how they are supposed to use and how they are not supposed to use. So sometimes just understanding the bills, we get to know some ideas, or we can understand why this month was so much, why this month has come more, or what all we have added, what we have not deleted. Like when you monitor every day, then you can come to know where sometimes something may go wrong. Like in this case, this curve was started going up suddenly. When the same consumption was happening, why the curve has gone up? When we studied, then it came to know that inverter battery was going wrong and it was drawing more current and consuming more to charge. So that way we avoided the battery going fully bad. So the basic mantra is that prepare budget and set targets to optimize consumption. So we should apply a basic mantra. Means basic mantra means, what, say for example, for light, provide light where it is needed, when it is needed, how much is needed, for what it is needed. It is linked with quality also. How much lux you need. So managing energy not only in terms of quality, but also not only in terms of quantity, but also quality. That is the mantra, means taking a task approach, and for completing that task, what is exactly required, how much is required, of what quality is required. For every task, if we ask this question, and then prepare a budget, and then set targets, so we can then almost approach the theoretical possible consumption, and then to control that, we need to introduce incentive and penalty scheme. Those who waste, they should be penalized. Those who save, they should be given incentive. And we can have some scheme where you collected fines, you know, we can 1/3 can be used to buy new efficient items, and 1/3 can be distributed cash reward, and so 1/3 can be used for some common picnic or anywhere. So to start with, we should start taking care of the ghost consumer. In our household, there are many, what you call phantom loads. Phantom loads means which are standby loads, and in a we named it as a ghost consumers. Without our realizing, those consumers consume electricity, like leaving TV, DVD, and all that on thermostat on remote. It keeps consuming, or not having the proper setting of fridge, or even TV, if you use it on higher more sound and or more light, it consumes more watt, or leaving the mosquito mat on. All these things are ghost consumers, which sometimes add up to 100 to 200 watt. And if you leave it on for 20 hours, so it consumes almost one to two units. In many homes, I have seen 1 to 2 units per day is taken away by the ghost, such ghost consumers. And I did some study and found out that the losses happens to be sometimes as much as, you can say, for 20 years equivalent to about 5 lakhs loss will happen. That too, if you calculate 5 rupees per unit rate. So we should also avoid all 0-watt bulb. Even many homes still have those so-called 0-watt bulb, which consumes actually 7.5 to 15 watt. So LED consumes only 0.5 watt for the same light. Go for solar water heater. Solar water heater I consider as the king of solar system, because it is the only system solar which saves energy. It doesn't generate in electricity. It saves electricity, and it really directly per rupee spent on solar water heater gives you more return than per rupee spent on solar lighting, generating more. Instead of generating more electricity, we save electricity. Thermostat setting for fridge. It is commonly given by all the manufacturers, some setting in winter 1 to 2 you keep, monsoon 3 to 4 you keep, summer 5 you keep. But in people don't understand, sometime I've seen full or sometime middle they keep. But it is need to be explained to them that it all relates to where are you. Like I am in Bangalore, somebody is in Delhi, somebody is in Mumbai. All cannot have the same instruction. So they need to be told how to set a thermostat of their fridge as per the use, and how to load the thermostat. That also many people don't understand. Then how to tell them this task lighting, task cooling. In my office, I had experimented, and instead of 200 watt load for one fan and two, three lights, I could manage with only 11 plus 5, 16 watt, 11 watt for the fan and 5 watt for the LED bulb. So this is another idea, use appliances smartly and intelligently. So how to use smartly and intelligently so that we don't add to the load. Like in for inverter people, load unnecessarily inefficient fans and lights. When they're told that when it again will recharge the battery, it will consume more, 15-20%. So use of LED lamps. LED lamps now, of course, is well known. I need not tell much. And if you have still your CFL, you can use wherever rarely used, you can put there. And you can phase out all T12, T8, T5 tube lights. And fans also now, we have fan, this one. Now super energy efficient fan have come, which consumes only 28 watt. By the way, I wanted to tell everyone, Kapil and others, there is no light here. So far, I was managing with my laptop battery. Now it has come to only 8%. I don't know when I will be out from this. There is no battery backup. and I am not seeing whether light will come back. So you can switch over to super energy efficient fan and also use AC with fans, because invariably people use AC with 2018 or even 22 degree centigrade. You can use, if you use fan with AC, you can set your AC thermostat for up to even 28, 29 degree centigrade, and try to not to go for this frost-free refrigerator, because frost-free refrigerators are inefficient. We should buy direct cool refrigerator. Of course, these old type of regulators and step regulators to be replaced. Then coming to water conservation measures, I've made one water pyramid, where again water conservation techniques, then how to go more have efficient gadgets, aerators, flow restrictors, self-closing taps, then how to set up drip irrigation for gardening if you have, then water level controller, that all comes under efficiency. And conservation techniques, and starting with zero, conducting water audit. You can conduct water audit and have your check your leakages and other things. And for renewal, for renewal means rainwater harvesting, reuse of water, reuse of grey water. And I have developed this idea of cleaning my car with 1 liter of water with a can. This can I use, I clean my car with 1 liter of water. This is the aerator. This saves water because air comes with water. Then how to save fuel? These are all PCRA techniques. Bad driving habits. People don't know driving properly, and they use unnecessary clutch and other things. Those techniques we have to learn. Fuel saving for cooking, and how to even now some people are promoting. Why to cook at all? Actually, we know only humans cook and eat, no other species cooks. So we can try eating raw veg and fruits, at least one diet we can have that. And of course, this ride share and carpooling, we should now, a lot of things are happening, personal cars or Ola and Uber, share taxis. This is one thing we should do. I won't recommend. Then recycling the Buddha way.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, this is about recycling. Waste minimization we need to do, and there are techniques how to minimize waste. This there is a inverted pyramid for waste also. Refuse, reduce, reuse, recycle. Healthy living, again, as I told, raw food, we should try to adopt raw food and fruits. That, because food and fruit is only, not only we save energy and water, we also minimize waste. Healthy living, of course, the best thing to avoid going to hospitals. Then now a lot of problems are happening due to waste. So this is suggested to adopt composting. And if you have place for gardening, you should try to grow your own food. Sustainable menstruation also is one way of minimizing waste, because a lot of sanitary napkin go to landfill or thrown out. Now a lot of ladies are using cups, which are reusable, washable, or washable pads. That can be used for 10 years. So you are minimizing, eliminating about 3,000 sanitary napkins going to a landfill. And last, right, whatever you bring home, you should conduct last, right? We should either sell it or donate it or somehow exchange it with somebody instead of lying. Here, this in this case, this scooter, they wanted to sell for 15,000. He didn't get offer for more than 12,000. He didn't sell. By the time he got offer for 12,000, the offer, by the time he agreed for 12,000, he was not getting even 10,000. So like that, the scooter is lying there and it will remain there. So better to get exchange or sell it or donate it to any. We should do that so that it goes into the recycle route. And we should promote green economy by you should join all eco-friendly groups, and also green items you should purchase, like alternative to plastic, then natural cleaners, then herbal, like this. So even you can make it as a policy to gift green items only instead of giving conventional items for any marriage or wedding or birthday parties. And try to think of, in every home there are some scope for innovative ideas to be applied. We should try that. And also be a participate, play a participatory role, and with the government, use your right to information, because it is not only your right, it is also your duty. Right to the authorities, write articles in newspapers, media campaigns. So take it up in an idea, make it your life mission. So think of it, dream of it. This is what I tell. Now I have around five minutes time. I can take up some questions, Kapil. I can take up some questions. Any questions, please? Hello? Any questions? Hello? 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 I am available for questions. If anyone has any questions, I can quickly take. I have 5 minutes backup.
You are unmuted.
Hello. Any question?
Hello. Good evening. Please, if anyone is having question, please mention your name in chat. We will unmute you so that you can ask questions.
Hello. 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 Hello.
Hello, good evening. If anyone is having question, he can write his name on chat. We will.
Hi, Sunil.
Hi.
Sir, this is Ashu.
Hi, Ashu. Hello. Hello. Hello, Ashu. Hello.
Ashu Gupta. Yeah, very good.
Hi.
Sir, very nice.
Hello.
Presentation. Thank you so much for giving the time, first of all. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Now I can hear you. Yeah, I can hear you. Hello. 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 Hello.
Yeah. Okay. I will do it now from your end. Hello. Hello. Hello, Ashu. Okay. Oh, yes. Okay, thank you. Actually, first time I didn't know how to do properly. Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you.
हो गया
सुमित? हो गया
अच्छा की मन लाइट नहीं है कार चली है कार जाके चाप पी के सो रही है थोड़ी देर 7 बजे तक ठंड का मौसम है कार जाके सो रही है
कार में जाके सो सकते हैं यार की गल कर रही
जाओ ना रंगी कार
चलो इतने पीछे आने हैं
God would see, no?
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah. Who called me?
Good
Thank you all. We are closing the session. Thank you very much.
Hello. Hello. Thank you.
Sorry. Oh, another bomb in there.